In this question, Daniel is painting the wall and ceiling of a cuboidal hall with length, breadth and height. Length is 15 meter, height, breadth is 10 meter and the height given to you is 7 meter respectively. From each can of paint, 100 meter square of area is painted. Means each can paint how much? 100 meter square of area. How many cans of paint will she need to paint the room? So first here, what is given to you? Length is given to you 15 meter, breadth is given to you 10 meter and height is given to you as 7 meter. So from here you can find out the total surface area of room that will be equal to length breadth plus 2 breadth h height plus height into length. From here you can, what is the length given to you is 15 and breadth is given to you as 10. Again breadth is given to you as 10 here into height is 7 plus again height into breadth is given to you as 15. So from here we will get 150 plus 2 into 70 plus 15 into 7, 5, 7 are 35, 5 are 3, 7 are 7, 8, 9, 10, 105. So this is 105 here. From here 150 plus 2 you will get 571. Okay. Now 150 plus 175 multiplied by 2. 5 2s are 10, 7 2s are 14, 9 1 50. This is 350. From here you will get 0, 4, 5, 6. From here you are getting 0, 5, 4, 5, 0 plus 0, 0, 5 plus 5, 10, 3, 4 and this is 5. The total surface area of the room is 500. You have to find out the required number of the can. So, required number of can, that's it, that will be equal to area of hall upon area of one can. So area of hall we have taken out, that is 500 upon area of one can, it is given to you as 100 meter square. From here divided by 100, this and this zero gets cancelled, so answer is 5. So how many can you will require to paint the room? You will make, therefore 5 can will be needed to paint the room. Question number 6. In this question it is saying, describe how the two figures at the right are alike and how they are different. Which box has the larger surface area? From the two, this is the cylinder, you have to find out the surface area of the cylinder, and this is the cube, you have to find out the surface area of the cube, and you have to find which box has the larger lateral surface area. So here first we will take the for this cylinder. Okay, so what we will do, what is given to you? Diameter of cylinder, that is D, it is given to you as 7. Radius R will be 7 by 2 because radius is R by 2. Okay, so that's why it will become 7 by 2. Height, it is given to you as 7. You have to find out the lateral surface area. So lateral surface area of the cylinder is, lateral surface area of cylinder pi r h. Okay, lateral surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi r h. Here the value of pi is 22/7. Okay, so 2 × 22/7. What is the radius given to you is 7/2, and the height given to you is 7. So this 7 gets cancelled, this 2 gets cancelled. From here you will get 7 × 2 = 14. 4 carry 1. Again 7 × 2 = 14 and 1 = 15. 154. So lateral surface area of the cylinder is given to you as 154 cm². Now this you have taken out for the first cylinder. Now what is given to you? The next figure is of a cube. So you have to find out the lateral surface area of the cube. So lateral surface area of the cube formula is 4 × side² lateral surface area of cube, it is 4 × side² so what is given to you, side is given to you, so 4 × side is 7² so 4 × 7 × 7 4 × 49 this will be 49 × 4 this will be 6 carry 3 196. So this will be 196 cm². So you have to find out that which box has the lateral largest surface area. So the cube has the largest surface area. From here you can clearly see this is 154 cm² and that is 196 cm². So which box has the larger lateral surface area? The cube has the, therefore the cube has the larger surface area. In this question number 7, it is given a closed cylindrical tank of radius 7 m and height is given to you is 3 m is made up from a sheet of metal. How much sheet of metal is required? So what is given to you? A closed cylindrical tank of radius, it is given to you as 7 m and height, it is given to you as 3 m, is made up from a sheet of metal. This is made up from a sheet of metal, and how many such sheets of metal you will require to make this tank, a closed cylindrical sphere of radius, this of metal, how much sheet of metal is required? So you have to find out the number of sheets required. So for this, what you have to do, you have to find out the total surface area of the cylinder. Total surface area of cylinder that is equal to 2h + r. So here you have to write down 2 pi r in bracket h + r. So now what you have to do is substitute the values of the radius and height. So here you are given with 2 into the pi value is 22/7. Radius is given to you as 7 m and height is given to you as 3 plus radius. From here you will get 2 × 22/7 × 7 × 10. So this 7 and this 7 gets cancelled. From here you will get 44 × 10, that is 440. So how many sheets of metal is required? 440 sheets of metal is required. 440 sheets of metal is required. This is the answer. And this question is saying A road roller takes 750 complete revolutions to 1 over 2 level a road. Move 1 over 2 level a road. Find the area of the road. If the diameter of a road roller is 84 cm and length is given to you in 1 meter. First you have to find out the area of the road. Firstly, what is given to you? A road roller takes 750 complete revolution. Means some 750 complete revolutions taken by the road roller to move a to move once to a level of a road. Now what you have to find? You have to find the area of the road. When you are given with diameter of the road is 84 cm and from here you can take out the radius and length is given to you in 1 meter. So 1 meter it is given and here you are having centimeter. So you will convert the meter into centimeter. So let's take out what is given to you. First is area of road roller is given to you as, here you are given with radius, diameter of road, it is given to you, roller is given to you as 84 centimeter. From here you can take out the radius of the roller, that is r by 2, d by 2, that is r, that is 84 by 2. So this will be 2 fours are 2, that is 42 centimeter. Now you are given with length. Length given to you is here as 1 meter. So you have to convert this meter into centimeter. So this will be 100 centimeter. Now you will find out the curved surface area of the road, that is equal to 2 pi r h. From here you are given with 2, value of pi is 22/7, and from here you are given with 2 pi r h. What is given to you? Height is given to you, length is 1 meter and road roller, this is given to you now. So this is equal to 2 pi r h. From here you can write out 2 into pi. What is given to you? R is given to you as 42 centimeter and here you will get 100 centimeter. So from here you can find out the value. From this you will get 7 ones are 7 sixes. This is 44 into 600. From here you will get 26400. So this is the curved surface area of the road. So now you are given with area, you have taken out area, curved surface area of road roller is this much. Now what is given to you? A road roller takes 750 complete revolution. So if you have to take out the, here you are there with the curved surface area of the road, that is this much. So this 750 complete revolution, you have to multiply this with 750. So from here, area covered by road roller is how much? 750. From here the area covered by the road roller is 750. So revolution, so what you will do, you will multiply 26400 into 750. When you multiply this you will get 1960000. Okay, this is in centimeter square. Now as you know that 1 meter square is equal to 10,000 centimeter square. Okay, so what you will do, you will divide 1960000 by 10,000, So this 4-0 and this 4-0 will get cancelled. You will remain with 1960. So find the area of the road. The area of the road is 1960. Then a company packages its milk powder in a cylindrical container. This is a container in which a company packages its milk powder. Milk powder is there whose base has a diameter of 14 cm. The diameter of this base is how much? 14 cm. Height is, total height of this container is how much? 20 cm. Company places a label around the surface of the container. If the label is placed 2 cm from the top and 2 cm from the bottom, so what is the area of the label? You have to find out the area of the label. What is given to you if the label is placed? Means here 2 cm in the down and at the top and at the bottom 2 cm is there. So what is given to you? Diameter. Okay, what is given to you? Diameter of this cylindrical. Diameter of cylindrical container, that is given to you as 40 cm. So from here you can find out the radius of this cylindrical centimeter, that is d by 2, 14 by 2, that is 7 cm. So radius you are given with how much? 7 cm. If company places a label around the surface container, if the label is placed 22 cm from top and 2 cm from the bottom, here height of the cylindrical is given to you as 20 cm. But here it is saying the label is placed 2 cm from the top and 2 cm from the bottom. So what you have to find out? Height of the container. Height of the container, that is 20, total it is given minus 2 from the top and minus 2 from the bottom, so this is 20 minus 4, that is 60. So what is the height of the container? 60 centimeters. Okay, now what you have to find out? What is the area of the label? So from here what you have to find out? The curved surface area of the label, that is here only I am writing, curved surface area of container is equal to 2 pi r h, that is 2 into 22 by 7, radius is given to you as 7 and height is given to you as 16. So on solving this you will get 22, 2 into 22 by 7, into 7 into 16. This 7 and this 7 gets cancelled, that is 44 into 16. So on multiplying this you will get how much? 704. So what you have to find out? What is the area of the label? So the area of the label here is 704 cm square. This is the answer.